Today, we will talk about another artwork by John Duncan Fergusson. Before the Second World War, Fergusson spent many years in France. It is here where he first met in 1904 Anne Estelle Rice, an American artist and illustrator for a Philadelphia magazine. Miss Rice and Fergusson both became active collaborators for the literary arts and critical review magazine called Rhythm, edited by John Middleton Murray and published in London between 1911 and 1913. Regarding visual art, Anne Estelle Rice took a similar path as Fergusson, adhering first to the Impressionist and later to the Fauvist movements. The portrait titled Anne Estelle Rice in Paris was completed by Fergusson in 1910. Reminiscent of the Impressionist tradition, the Ollon board was executed en plein air, and specifically set in the fashionable neighborhood of Montparnasse, with the Café Closerie de Lilas in the background. The harsh brushstrokes, the vivid colors, and the use of green to represent shadowed areas indicate Fergusson's first experiment with Fauvist portraiture. He supported Matisse's ideal of art as a means of emotive expression, in which colors are used to evoke the emotional and intellectual features of the subject. Let's talk about Miss Rice's gaze towards the viewer. She's not only a woman scrutinized by us, it rather goes against what the feminist critique labeled in the 1970s as the male gaze, a sexualized way of looking that empowers men and objectifies women. Therefore, women become the spectacle and men are the bearers of the look. Here, Miss Rice subverts the male gaze and defies the observer when looking directly at us. Fergusson depicts a confident woman who chooses an outward gaze, focusing on challenging the viewer rather than considering how the viewer sees her.